بسم الله. Can we discuss this matter? When we discuss something about religion, we discuss it for a purpose. I mean, when we argue about something in religion, we are supposed to argue for a purpose. That purpose should be to show the truth or to understand the truth. If you are not sure about what you has been is you, what you are arguing about, so you have to listen to carefully. If you hear anything that you should follow, you have to follow it. When you are sure that the adversary is wrong, then you try to explain to him so he follows the right thing that you are following, so he comes to the right on which you are. Not people are not supposed to argue, so they win. Huh? Who is going to win, who is going to lose? That is not the right thing to do. The Prophet said, لا تختلفوا كما اختلف يا أيها الناس لا تختلفوا فإن من قبلكم قد اختلفوا فهلكوا. All people don't divide. Because people before you differed and they were perished. The Prophet as well said اقرأوا القرآن ما أتلفت عليه قلوبكم. Read the Quran as long as you gather on it, that your hearts gather on it. When you differ, stand up, leave. So now when people start debating about something, they should try to come to the right conclusion. If they can't come to the right conclusion and it's going nowhere, they have to stop. Most of the time, if they can't get to the same opinion, it's because some people, one of the two people who are debating, or one of the two groups, it's because one of these two people is following his desire, doesn't want to understand. If they really want to understand and want to follow the truth, it's very difficult not to reach an agreement. It is possible sometimes, yes, because the way people think. But generally, this is why people try to understand to argue. Not every argument is haram, but if you argue just to win the argument, that is definitely haram. Allah Ta'ala said, وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ أَكْثَرَ شَيْءٍ جَدَلًا. That human, if you don't understand translation, don't let me.
وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ
أَكْثَرَ شَيْءٍ جَدَلًا.
Mankind, there were people who they were most in argument. They did arguments a lot.
They argue a lot. Arguing when you are wrong, this is haram. If you think you are right and you want to give the message to the other person, that's fine, you can't argue. If you argue because you are not sure about what you know and you want to get more knowledge, that's fine as well. Inshallah, today we are going to read this book, start with this book of Ibn Hajar. And because we have different opinions amongst the people of knowledge, most of the time, of course, we mention the four imams, the four imams. This is what people normally, they always refer to these four: Abu Hanifa, Malik, Shafi'i, and Ahmad ibn Hanbal. But inshallah, I will be referring to the fifth madhab. People say four madhab. They are right. Truth is, there is no four madhab. And four madhab are wrong. Muslims are one madhab. However, there is the fifth madhab, and I believe they are right. Why? Because this madhab, they say they don't have an imam other than the Prophet. Amongst them, they never refer to a person. They don't. They differ amongst themselves. Nobody follow the other. Like the Hanafis follow Abu Hanifa all the time. Like the Shafi'is follow Shafi'i all the time. Like the Malikis follow Malik all the time. And the Hanbalis with the Ahmad ibn Hanbal. These people they call Zahiris. These people, they have different opinions. They don't follow Dawood, they don't follow Ibn Hazm, they don't follow... There are many people like this. And the common thing about them, that they say we shouldn't follow anyone except the Prophet. We shouldn't follow except Quran and Sunnah. And this madhab is not mentioned most of the time, even though amongst them there are some well-known people like Dawood al-Zahiri, and I don't believe that he called himself Zahiri, and Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri. They are very well-known. It's very difficult to open any book of fiqh or hadith where they will not refer to these people and they take their opinion. They are most, amongst people of knowledge, they are most more famous than Nawawi and Ibn Taymiyyah and Ibn al-Qayyim. And nobody will compare these people to those because their words are considered well. Their saying is very, it's acceptable, it's taken into consideration, not like Ibn al-Qayyim, Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn Taymiyyah, he says, Ahmad ibn Hanbal has said it, because he's Hanbali, or Ibn al-Qayyim, or Nawawi, he is Shafi'i after all, or Tahawi, he is Hanafi. So he didn't really do much contribution. He is always, he just take the, what his Imam has said, and then try to bring support what he said. Even though these people, you may have not heard about them before. People of knowledge, people who study fiqh and hadith, they know about them. The different, yeah, this is other thing. One thing different that these people have, the difference between these people and Nawawi or Ibn al-Qayyim or Ibn Kathir or these well famous people, is in their books, yeah, when they write, they, because they don't follow anybody except the Prophet, they don't spend a lot of time and energy trying to show that someone is right. You see, when you follow two people, the madahib who say we have an imam, we have to follow him, they are following two people. We believe that they follow the Prophet, but then they follow the imam, and then the imam is not always right, sometimes says things that contradict the Prophet. And here it's very difficult for them to make judgment who to follow. And sometimes they even they decide to follow the imam, where it's clearly, where it's clear that the imam is wrong. These people are not that bad. They are people that we think are good. Where they think the imam is good, is wrong, they will say what they think is the truth, but then we spend a lot of time trying to show that, oh yeah, he didn't mean it. He wants to say what he is saying is almost right. You see, he's trying to praise him in any way, and it's not necessary. It's just a human being. You don't have to follow another human being. Someone who is like this, it's very difficult when there is two sayings, two understanding, and they are almost, you see, so it's not possible that two understanding of hadith contradicting each other both right. It's not possible. Why? Because there is it's only either true or wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ذلكم الله وربكم الحق. That is your Lord, the truth. فماذا بعد الحق إلا الضلال. What is after the truth except misguidance? So if it's not true, it's misguidance. There is no anything in between.
Why,
that is Surah Yunus. Surah Yunus, but I don't... Surah Yunus in the fourth page in the bottom. Anyway. So these people will spend time trying to prove that their imam is what he is saying is right. Some of them, actually, many of them, will say that the imam is right all the time. You find this many Hanafis who do this, and you find many Malikis who do this. It's less amongst the Shafi'is and Hanbalis.